Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This is your boy Bashiro. So, with the ending of the Guilty Gear Strive beta, I'm felt kinda empty, to be honest. I'm not motivated to play a lot of fighting games, so I'm starting to feel nostalgic and I'm looking back at some of the fighting game like announcement trailers that get me really hyped. So these are some of my favorites, and this is all basically personal opinion, and you will see in this video why I love Blazblue so much. So most of it is Blazblue, but fighting game announcement trailers, they're always hype, and I feel like with the recent years they're starting to go down a little bit in quality. But here are some of my favorites. Definitely let me know in the comments below what are your favorite fighting game announcement trailers, so we can just share the hype, you know, and live in the moment. Okay, so the first one that I really loved actually is the BB Tag announcement trailer. That caught me really off guard, and it was really wild. It's like a Mugen game coming back, like, to real life, you know? So I really love this trailer. Because first it starts like, it's Ragna Engine. Oh my god, it's a new Blazblue? We just had BBC F. Then, oh my god! Then you see like the characters from Eunice, you see Yuu Narukami. And then you see like, oh my god, it's like a 2v2 game. Like what they are doing, you know? That game felt like a dream, to be honest. When it first announced, it didn't feel real. It's like Blazblue, Eunice, Persona. Cross tag battle, it's a 2v2 fighting game, like wow! You know? So, to be honest, that announcement was really hype. And it was really, oh my god, I remember how I felt about it. And like, you thought it's ended? You have Ruby Rose! Ruby coming to Blazblue! And she looks so beautiful! You know? Like, for me, this game, like when it first was announced, it was like a dream coming true, to be honest. It's like Blazblue, Persona, Under Night, and then Ruby, they're all in one game. It's like 2v2, like what's gonna happen, what's gonna change, you know? So really the announcement of BB Tag, regardless of what's your opinion of the game now and like what's its state, to be honest, the announcement was really hype. And for me, until now, I like to watch it because it puts a smile on my face, and It really turned out to be a good game at the end. I really love BB Tag. So let's look at my next favorite one. If you are talking about character announcement trailers, this is the only trailer, to be honest, that's one of my favorite character announcement trailers, because this is a character I've been looking forward to play since the first time I lay my hands on Blazblue. So I'm gonna shut up and I'm gonna let you watch this video. Because really, I'm okay. I'm shutting up now. Saya playable. When I first saw this, I lost my shit. Not gonna lie. Like, she's wearing her kimono and she's a respectable woman, like, خلاص. I really love that trailer. I remember the hype. Let's go! Dawardo! Oh my god. This is one of my favorite moves in any fighting game. I swear to god, every time I watch that video, I get goosebumps. Izanami is one of my favorite fighting game characters of all time, and I've been wanting to play like as Saya, like since the first Blazblue, and since I saw her as a boss character in Chrono Phantasma, I was hoping they would put her as a playable character. So this trailer caught me by surprise, and it's until now one of my favorite character announcements, because that character turned out amazing. And I was counting the days until I can get my hand on Blazblue Central Fiction. The next one basically is the announcement of Blazblue Central Fiction, because we knew a new Blazblue is coming, but we didn't know when exactly. And basically, for me, by the way, my love to Blazblue, it came from the story mode more than the actual gameplay. So I was really wanting to see like how the story will end. So when they announced Phase 4 is the last Blazblue like story of Ragnar the Blood Edge, it sent chills in my body. Oh my god, that music. Okay, I'll shut up and I'll let you watch. That's a new character for Central Fiction. Basically during the hype of Attack on Titan. I really wanted to see how the story will wrap up. All your characters coming back. This feels so good. This is before Izanami's announcement. I really miss Blazblue. God. Plus, when you see new moves for your character, you get hyped. This makes me upset, to be honest. I need a Blazblue, goddamn. I really miss Blazblue. I miss it a lot. For all of you horny boys, you know who's this character. There was a one frame in this trailer that drove my friends crazy. Let's see how fast my reactions are until now. See the new logo of Blazblue. Then, see, I still have reactions. This 1 second frame shot, this drove all my friends nuts because they always wanted to play as Nine. And they give her to us, and she's the most toxic character in Blazblue. We'll turn it down a notch. To be honest, when Granblue first came out, Granblue Fantasy Versus, I wasn't really excited too much about it. So I think I was like, I liked Fairy, but I was looking for a character with more style. Because I loved that she stopped here, but I wanted more another character like to resonate with me. So when they announced Zoe, to be honest, for me that was really, really good. And she's actually my main character in this game, whenever I'm playing it. I really love Zoe. And I feel like Granblue trailers, even though they are short, they explain a lot about her character. I love her because she has the floof, you know? Dragon, sword. I feel like she's a really well-designed character. She's kinda weak in Granblue, but she just recently got buffed, so let's see how good she is now. I loved her moveset. I love that she has a sword and shield with dragons. I love the idea that she has zoning. A lot of people were hyping up like her mix-up, but I feel like if you know how to block in any fighting game, you can block her mix-up easily, you know? But I really loved her character design. I loved the way she looked. And when I saw that, I was like, oh my god, a character with a real mix-up, you know? Fairy was a real mix-up character, but she was too top-tier my conscience sometimes used to attack me. I thought this was comboable, but they removed it eventually. I love Zoe. I like her. I feel like she's the saving grace of Granblue Fantasy Versus for me. For me, that trailer was really hype, and that's the time that my interest really, really picked up in Granblue. I felt like I want to play the game more. Because I was happy with Fairy, but I wanted a character that will resonate with me personally, that I can develop an attachment. So that was really good. I really loved that trailer. Now I'm going to show you the trailer. It shows in the title. But now I'm going to show you the trailer that actually got me excited to Guilty Gear Strive. Because if you've been following my channel for a while, you will know that I had very little interest in Guilty Gear Strive. So this is the trailer that actually got me hyped to the game. Not gonna lie. This is real talk, boys. This trailer led me to play Guilty Gear Strive. My girl with the swords, with the hat, with the military look. See, ooh, the death look, you know. You don't mess with my girl. Swords. I'm speculating at that time. How can they change her gameplay? You know? See, you're not escaping from the corner. Stay down. You're trying to backdash? Back to the corner with you. Who are you? Oh my god. I loved when they showed this move. Hello, we played the game and we know how good everything is. I wasn't a big fan of the new music, but I want to hear the full thing. This combo, we need to try it in full release. I remember I post my thumbnail with that cheeks. To be honest, some of those animations before the move comes out, they look kind of dumb, not gonna lie. But this is the trailer that actually got me to play Guilty Gear Strive. You heard it here first. Lastly, 2013, Ayman couldn't sleep after he watched the trailer. That was almost 8 years ago. This is the trailer that let me lose sleep. If you follow my channel, you know how much I love Blazblue. So when I saw that two of my favorite characters of all time are coming to Blazblue Chrono Fantasma with a new look, with a new soundtrack, with the new moves, oh my god, that was the best thing ever. I think I would rate this as one of my favorite, maybe my favorite. Just don't mind the quality, I cannot find a better one. God, that sickness. Oh! Number 13. Okay, oh, mode change! Oh, mode change was one of the best features of this character. See? Ooh. Change mode combo. Voila, Blazblue Chrono Fantasma was amazing. That's the first time we started to see like overdrive things. Change, oh my god, she was really, really well designed. I don't know why they changed her that much in Central Fiction. Okay. Number 13. You don't forget about number 12. The protector of the world. The villain turned hero. Mew 12. You don't forget about her. You don't forget about her. And I didn't forget about her. Oh my god, the music. Oh! See, the new move. Woo! I remember I was... Ah! Oh my god. We don't listen yet to the lyrical version. Ah! New Astral, new moves. Ah! I really, 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 really love this trailer. Because at the end, you think it's only number 12. You think it's only number 13. It is number 0. You haven't seen anything yet. This is the downfall of Blazblue. This is when the poison seeped into Blazblue. This is when I started to hate Blazblue. This character is cancer. This character, you know yourself who plays this character. You know this character is cancer. Yeah. Okay, guys, that's it. Enough nostalgia tripping, okay? Definitely let me know in the comments which trailer like really got you hyped up for a character or a fighting game. Because for me, I have very deep emotional attachment with Blazblue. So anything that was Blazblue related during my days really used to get me hyped up. And to be honest, Blazblue was the only fighting game I used to play before I got my eyes open. So anything new Blazblue related used to get me riled up. So this is some of my favorite trailers. Definitely let me know which trailers get you hyped like this. And now I have energy to continue my evening. And guys, as always, thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Yalla, peace.